on what Volvo models is collision warning with emergency brake available? Well, as it is now becoming a legal requirement from 1st of November 2015, it will be available on all of our models from FL, FE, FM, FMX, and FH, as well as, of course, FH16. Kevin wants to know, how wide does the vehicle in front of the truck have to be for the system to detect it? Well, as we are using two sensors, both the radar and the camera, we can use the camera to detect how wide the object in front of us is. And therefore, it's fairly easy to observe if it is a bus or a truck, or even all the way down to a motorbike. Here's a real technical question. What happens if the radar gets covered with snow? And well, as the radar is mounted on the front of the truck here, we can get a snow buildup here. What happens then is that the driver will be alerted of this on the dash, saying that the radar is covered. And of course, then the driver has to take over himself. Now, another thing we should think of here is that this is just a cover over the radar. Remember, never paint it with metallic paint. Don't put extra lights or something in front of it, because then the system will definitely not be working. And we can have a look and see the radar behind this cover. Here you can actually see the radar unit itself. Peter M. Fenny wonders, why doesn't the system apply the brakes a second earlier and leave a few extra meters between the truck and the other car? Well, the easy answer there is, it's not a comfort system. This is an emergency braking system and should only be used as the last resort. Because honestly, we don't really want to apply the brakes at all. We want to alert the driver and make sure that the driver does what the driver should be doing, looking forwards in front of it. Nico Villak wants to know if it's possible for a truck to drive completely autonomous using the technique and knowledge we have today, not taking into account the current traffic laws. And yes, trucks can be driven autonomously. But in the beginning, we will only be seeing that in restricted areas, such as mines or in a port where you could do that. To see it on normal roads is going to take quite some time. Glenn Norman is concerned with what happens to the traffic behind the truck when the emergency braking system is activated. Well, we've been thinking a lot about this, and when the system goes into a panic braking mode, and the retardation is more than 2.5 meters per square second, which is a fairly fierce braking, then the brake lights are activated, so they start blinking. They go from a fixed light to a blinking light. And then as the vehicle slows down and the truck goes below 5 kilometers per hour, then we also put on the hazard light. Something a lot of you asked is, what happens to the load when the emergency braking system is engaged? Well, nothing really, is the simple answer, because the load should of course be secured. Whether it's the driver that is putting on the brakes or the emergency braking system that is doing that, there's no difference. The load should be secured, as it always should be. Another common question is how important the road condition is. What happens to the system if it's slippery, for example? Well, what we are looking into there is that we are applying the brakes as much as we can. And as a foundation for the whole system, we have the ESC, Electronic Stability Control, and also, of course, EBS, Electronic Braking System. So we are using the brakes as much as possible, depending on the road conditions. But of course, if it's slick ice, well, then it's going to be a little more difficult to stop the vehicle, and you're going to have a much longer distance before the truck stops. Andrian has an idea for another solution. He asks, wouldn't it be better to just lower the speed to the vehicle's in front speed instead of making the truck come to a full stop? Well, that's exactly what we do. We monitor the vehicle in front of us, and should the object pull away or move out of our direction, then we release the brakes again. Ben Carlton states that this should be standard on all heavy vehicles and actually a new legal demand. Correct. That is exactly what is happening. From the 1st of November 2015, this will be a legal requirement called for on all heavy vehicles, also together with lane keeping support, which also will be then a legal requirement at the same date. Another common question is, at what speed range does the system work? And the easy answer there is, it works from 15 kilometers per hour up to full speed. Is there any risk of a false alarm, that the truck's emergency brakes for no reason? How good is the system at detecting false dangers? This is one of the real challenges with the system, because a false braking is really not allowed. And therefore we are running lots of tests, much more tests than we need to fulfill the legal requirements. So we're trying the system not only on straight roads, we're testing it in curves, all different traffic situations, to make sure that we do not get false detections or false interventions. Ben Mesoud wonders how the anti-lock system works for the wheels. What happens is that when the truck brakes, we apply the brakes, the tires, wheels slow down. As they start to stop, we then release the brakes again so the wheel can start moving. And then we reapply the brakes. And this is done very quickly with the anti-lock system. And this gives us maximum performance irrespective of what the road conditions are. Some of you also want to know if the system works together with stretch brake, which is our active safety system that prevents the truck and trailer from jackknifing. Well, to be honest, the two systems aren't really connected to each other. But if you are in a situation where you are using the stretch brake and an object or slow vehicle is in front of you and you don't observe it, well, of course, then the emergency braking system will take over and do an emergency stop. One question is, how many lives will the system actually save? And of course, that's very difficult to answer, but as rear-ending, where the system is very active, is the second most common accident type after rollovers, where you have fatalities, we will definitely see a difference when the trucks start using the system. Talking about the legal requirements of the system, there are set standards there that you should fulfill. Now, we have done even more than that, and one of the important things is, for instance, the red light, the red flashing light that we project on the windscreen. This is something different and will be very helpful to alert the drivers. It's also the performance in all different types of situations, not only straightforwards, but also in curves and so on. One question that we receive fairly often is, what happens if the driver already has his foot on the brake pedal, he's seen the situation, will the system do anything then? Well, yes, the system will brake harder if necessary. So the easy way to answer that is, the strongest one will win.